to be called?
Weight? No weight. We're priority. I'm a platinum, you're a platinum. That's how we do it. That's it. That's how we roll.
That's how we roll.
We're in Ailey Beach, which is considered the heart of the Great Barrier Reef. So what I want to do is I want to provide you with just three separate locations that provide different tours off the boat so that you can have a comparison between tours that the ship offers and tours that are offered off the boat. So these are the three that I want to show you. Here's some costs for tours from the travel shop here in Ailey Beach. And here's some costs for some tours from Happy Travels. Here's the last bit of costs from this location. One of the cool little spots down here in Ailey Beach is this little lagoon area where you can come and swim. They have a little side that's obviously a little deeper for the adults. And then on that far side, smaller area where little kids can go and swim. And then they have this other pool behind me. And then they have this area for, it's like mainly adults. Obviously the kids can be on the perimeter, little lap area for the adults to swim. So this is an added surprise here in Ailey Beach.
So I bought a bacon and egg sandwich off the boat. And because they're cooking bacon right outside, and how can you pass up bacon? Especially Australia bacon, which by the way is the best bacon in the world. Mmm, good. Bacon, egg, bread. Can't beat it, delicious.
Well, we caught breakfast here. We just don't have time to get lunch. And I'm telling you, probably should have budgeted our time better, because not only do they cook a great breakfast sandwich, it looks like they cook a great burger as well. So the Big Unknown, if you're gonna stop off the Carnival cruise ship or any cruise ship, come and see the Big Unknown. They make great breakfast, great lunch.
I guess no stop would be correct if you don't have one Irish pub to go to. So Paddy's Shenanigans. Not going there, but just letting you know.
Well, if you want to taste the New Zealand, I guess the place to come is Ailey Beach, Australia.
I guess if you live in Ailey Beach, you know, you might as well meet Harrison. Heads out the hammock, sits out here, has a read, and enjoys the weather.
Someone was telling me to set up a shop here, hammock.
You could, dude. Yeah, I'm telling you, man. You could probably rent those things out, bro.
Yeah, I know.
But thank you so much. You enjoy the day, brother.
Well, welcome to Cairns, Australia. I was told that if you don't book anything from the ship, or if you don't pre-book something prior to getting to Cairns, it's virtually impossible to get any of those types of excursions that everybody wants to do. So wish me luck. I'm out to prove some people wrong. And so what I did is, you know, I took two different Ubers to places I thought I was supposed to go to. Trying to get onto the steam train, couldn't get on it, got to the Skyrail, so I'm hoping that I can get from the Skyrail to the train and take the steam train down here in Cairns. So, wish me luck.
There are two different stops. We get off at the first one, and nice wooded walkways that you can come on and walk through. A little slippery, so probably walk a little bit slower if you need some help. Then,
so this is stop number two. Here on the Skyrail, gonna head down to the waterfall. Looking forward to that.
A little closer look of the waterfall, different perspective.
But looks like I got pretty lucky on this Skyrail tour. Still got a little ways to go. The two stops that we've done so far have been breathtaking.
great views from it. The cable car ride is wonderful. It's smooth. So it's been enjoyable so far. And I'm really glad I took the adventure to get off the boat and go ahead and see if I can get something done today.
As you know, I got a round trip ticket on the Skyrail because I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to take the train back town, because everything seems to get sold out when the cruise ships are on in port, which is understandable. But I gambled it, and luckily a couple seats came open here a little bit ago. So I'm going to take the train ride back down. I hope you like it.
You know, as I'm waiting for the train at the Carondelet Railway Station, I can't help but think about that song. You know, sitting downtown at the railway station, one toe over the line, one toe over the line, sweet Jesus, one toe over the line. I know, I'm sorry. That was pretty bad.
Well, here's the train car that I am in. I am in car number one, and I am in seat number 17. Last minute ticket by the window. So first stop on the railway down to the city is at Barron Falls. Where do you see this?
Obviously a different view from the falls here on this side. And if you remember, first view off of the sky.
So Morton Island, from what I've read, 95% of this island is a national park, of the entire island. There's only an estimated 300 residents on this entire island. So it's more of a resort place, you know, to come. So obviously when the ship is in town, this place gets overrun with cruisers, but it's absolutely beautiful. The beach is breathtaking. We've already gotten in trouble though. Walking on the quad park area. That was Carrie's idea, not mine. Got us in trouble. Almost got kicked off the island, deported. But we're going to enjoy the day. We're going to go, snooba diving today. Yay, excited. As you can see, Carrie looks so excited about going into the freezing water. But remember, it was something that we both wanted to do. And we knew that we're coming here in the winter, which means the water's probably going to be cold. But it's going to be awesome. It's going to be the best ever.
So you know, we've had these wetsuits on for over a half an hour. It's cold. And now we're going to go to the boat ride for another half an hour in the cold. Then we're going to swim and get our head wet and everything in the water, which the water isn't cold. I know, it's not cold. It's not bath water, but it's not freezing. Anyway.
How long is this going to go?
And then we come back and we have to go in the boat. It's going to be cold. I don't like cold.
Oh well. It's going to be good.
look at that, boys. Look at it.
Whoa. All right, well, the Great Barrier Reef cruise has come to an end. It was a little disappointing, to say the least, and that was really due to not being able to go to Port Douglas due to some high seas, and then passing up Willis Island because there was some scheduled or routine maintenance that was said that had to be done to the ship. We don't think it was really routine maintenance. Very rarely are you doing routine maintenance in the middle of a cruise that requires divers. We all felt something the night we left, the day we left Port Douglas in the middle of the night, around 2 a.m, we heard this loud thumping crash. I mean, it woke us up and woke several people up. I don't think we hit anything. I just think something got rattled, and therefore it caused the captain to make a decision that we needed to pass up Willis Island and get the ship looked at. You know, his number one priority is to make sure that we're safe and that his crew is safe as well. So decisions captains have to make, and that's the way it goes. But Airlie Beach was fun. We enjoyed it. We enjoyed getting off of that. We enjoyed going to the market, enjoyed going to the beach, walking around town. It is a beautiful little place. Then obviously Cairns was my highlight. I loved it. Loved getting off the boat, going on the sky rail and the train excursion that I did all on my own. Didn't have to do it from the ship or didn't buy it from a tour guide. I just went out there, got an Uber to the sky rail and enjoyed a beautiful day. The rest of it was really out to sea. Miss Port Douglas, miss Willis Island. And then we ended up in Morton Beach where we did an excursion, and man, was the water cold, but we had a lot of fun. At the end, the Great Barrier Reef cruise was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. Remember guys, as always, you know, subscribe to the channel, push the like button, push the notification button, but also what's most important to Kerry, or at least to me, is the comments. Put some comments down there, some things that you enjoyed, some things that you wish you saw, some things that we could do better, some things that I could do better to help you as we put this out there for you to enjoy and experience our travels. Remember, as always, people, just continue to keep dreaming and travel safe. I'll talk to you later.